Hello everyone, welcome to our 20th lecture. This is our part 3 of types of circuit breaker. In this lecture we'll see about or we'll discuss about sulfur hexafluoride circuit breaker, that means SF6 circuit breaker. In the past, for high voltage application we are using OCB as well as ABCB, but nowadays for high voltage application we are using SF6 circuit breakers. OCB and ABC are almost obsolete. Most modern high voltage circuit breaker use SF6 gas for electrical insulation as well as arc interruption. Sulfur hexafluoride gas have many properties. Sulfur hexafluoride is an inert insulating gas which is increasingly popular in modern switchgear design, both as an insulating medium as well as arc quenching medium. The properties of SF6 gas are superior to those other type of interrupting medium, such as its high dielectric strength as well as high thermal conductivity. Some physical properties of SF6 gas. SF6 gas is 5 times heavier than air. It does not have any color, smell or odor. It is non-toxic, but when it decomposes into SF2 and SF4, these two are toxic. There is no risk of fire as SF6 gas is non-inflammable. The heat transfer rate of SF6 is about 2.5 times that of air at atmospheric pressures. Some useful characteristics of SF6 gas, because of that we are using nowadays SF6 gas or SF6 circuit breaker is preferred over ABCBs and OCBs. SF6 gas absorbs the free electrons in the arc path to form immobile negative ions to build up high dielectric strength. You know, when contact gets separated, there is a formation of arc. Formation of arc means that means there is more free electrons. But the property of SF6 is gas is that it absorbs the free electrons. That means the electric negativity property of this is SF6 gas, it absorbs the free electrons. So that's why it buildup of high dielectric strength is faster. SF6 gas has high thermal conductivity, which means that heat dissipation capacity is more. That's why this implies greater current capacity when contact gets surrounded by SF6. Next property or important properties. These are all important properties or important characteristics of SF6 gas. SF6 gas is an inert gas, so in normal condition, the metallic part in the contact with the gas are not corroded. As it is inert gas, so the breaker contacts will not get corroded. This ensures the life of breaker and reduces the need for maintenance. Also, one important property, most important property, the gas is quite stable. Stable means what? Whenever arc form, there is a ionization. Okay, when arc get extinguished, there is a deionization process. Between ionization and deionization, the gas get converted into fluoride of sulfur ions, and after the arc get extinguished, it reforms into original form. However, it disintegrate to other fluoride of sulfur in the presence of arc, but after the extinction of the arc, the SF6 gas is reformed from the decomposition. Figure 14.21 shows a part of typical non-puffer type of circuit breaker. Okay, this SF6 circuit breaker are two types, non-puffer type and puffer type. Okay, these two are SF6 circuit breakers. Okay, type of construction. One is non-puffer type construction and second is puffer type construction. This is non-puffer type SF6 circuit breaker. To this air reservoir, the gas reservoir is connected. In non-puffer type, gas reservoir is connected. The circuit breaker houses two contacts, namely fixed contact and a moving contact, which are enclosed in an arc interruption chamber. The interruption chamber is connected to the reservoir filled with high pressure SF6 gas. In closed position, the contact remains surrounded by SF6 gas at a pressure of 2.8 kg per centimeter square. During opening of high pressure, SF6 gas at 14 kg per centimeter square from its reservoir flows towards the chamber by wall mechanism. Okay. From this SF6 gas will flow from the reservoir. Okay, it will go like this. This is our fixed contact. This is moving. Initially, it is closed. As this starts separating, air, that gas will come from this side and are get interrupted. The fixed contact has hollow cylinder contacts and contains a set of current carrying contacts with an arcing horn. The moving contact is also a hollow cylinder with rectangular holes at the sides to let the SF6 gas out through these holes after flowing along and across the arc. In non-puffer type SF6 circuit breaker, there is a closed gas circuit for arc quenching medium. Further, it also contains two pressure system, low and high pressure. Initially, it is pressure is 2.1. After that, it is 14 kg per centimeter square. So, in non-puffer type, we had two pressure, while in puffer type, we have only one pressure. Okay, now we'll see in non-puffer type, these are fixed contact, this is moving contact. Arc gets stuck as soon as fault occurs, relay gives tripping signal to the circuit breaker, then circuit breaker contacts open, arc will form. Now SF6 gas will come from the reservoir and it quenches the arc. Okay, whatever gas will go out from this side. In this, holes are also given on this movable contact. Rectangular holes are given to move out the, there it is outlet for this gas flow. Okay, this is about your non-puffer type SF6 circuit breaker. Second, we switch over to the puffer type SF6 circuit breaker. The puffer type circuit breaker is designed in its simplest form with a single pressure system. In puffer design, the blast of gas necessary for cooling of the arc is achieved through mechanical compression during the opening operation of the breaker. During the opening operation, only closed chamber is there. Closed chamber is there. You know, this is our fixed position. This is fixed position. This is fixed contact and this is moving contact. Initially, it is closed. Okay. After the fault occur, relay gives tripping signal to the circuit breaker. Circuit breaker contacts opens. Okay. So, this is fixed contact. This fixed contact is as it is. With this moving contact separates. Here there is a gas. This is your fixed position. This is fixed position. Okay. Now this moving contact, this complete complete mechanism goes like this. Okay. While moving in this direction, it will move like this. Okay. Away from the fixed contacts. While moving, it compresses the air. So this pressure is constant. It is 14 kg per centimeter square, and that blast is on the air, on this arc. Now because of this, this arc get quenched. Okay, look here, cylinder is there, fixed contact and moving contact. Okay, now arcing. Here initially closed, this is initially closed. Okay, now it starts separating. Whatever gas inside this get compressed, and that pressure, that gas at get as higher pressure is stuck on this arc. So this arc get extinguished. Okay, again this is connected to your gas chamber, gas reservoir, but it is away from that. Okay, it is in the closed position. This is about our puffer type. Now, advantages of SF6 circuit breaker. Due to superior arc quenching property of SF6, such breakers have very short arcing time. Means, arc get quenched easily. Or, it have short arcing time. The arcing time is less. Dielectric strength of SF6 gas is 2 to 3 times that of air. Such breakers can interrupt much larger current. Gives noiseless operation due to its closed gas circuit. Closed gas enclosure keeps the interior dry so that there is no moisture problem. There is no risk there is no risk of fire. As SF6 gas is non-inflammable, there are no carbon deposits as it is inert gas, low maintenance cost, light foundation requirement and minimum auxiliary equipment. SF6 breakers are totally enclosed and sealed from atmosphere. They are particularly suitable where explosion hazards are there. Okay, so these are the many important advantages of SF6 circuit breaker. That's why over OCB and ABCB, SF6 circuit breaker are preferred. This is all about your SF6 circuit breaker. Thank you very much.